Praise God. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank and praise you for blessing us to be here this evening. We just thank you for being in our midst. And we thank you for your word to go out and not return void. In Jesus' name, amen. If I was going to have a subject, it would still be man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Because I realize that if we do not know the word of God, we cannot live by the word of God. Let's take a look at Romans 8 chapter, starting at the first verse. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do in that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit, if so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. And if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin, but the Spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the same Spirit of him that raised Jesus from the dead live in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit that dwell in you. And that's the Holy Spirit. Amen. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors not to the flesh to live after the flesh. For if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Amen. Amen. The song said, it's my honor, it's my joy to honor you in all I do. God expects us to honor him in everything that we do when we become Christians and become saved. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him there was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of man. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of that light, that all men through him might be saved. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But to as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to those that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. The law came by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. In the beginning, God did create the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. For by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth and under the earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him, and by him all things consist. Amen. Now we know that, but there are some that do not know that God created and made everything. There are some that do not know that he is all in all. But we're here. We're the Christians. We're the light of the world. We can't forget that. We cannot forget that we're the light of the world.
Amen.
And we must be doing what the song say, you know, honoring God all the time. Don't be intimidated by the enemy, but always let your light shine for Jesus, because one day this earth is going to pass away. You know, you go to the hotel and they say, well, you know, if you don't, we're trying to save the energy. We're trying to conserve this. If you don't want your sheets washed every day, you know, we want to do that. Well, we're paying every day for full price. So I'm not sleeping on dirty sheets. But the earth is passing away anyway. You can't save the earth. It's passing away. But you know, and I'm not talking about being wasteful. I'm talking about we can't save it. It's going to pass away. So the best thing for us to do is share the gospel, get them wrapped up in the word so they can be in Jesus when it comes. Hallelujah. But we can preach the gospel.
Amen.
We can preach the gospel. We can do that. That is not going to pass away. He that, you know, doeth the will of God abideth forever. Matthew 4:4 say, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. The Amplified say, man shall not live and be upheld or sustained by bread alone, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. Do you know every word that comes forth from the mouth of God? Of course we don't. But we're told to meditate in the word day and night, so we can observe to do all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosper, the scriptures say. And then thou shalt have good success. He didn't say work yourself to death for good success. He said meditate in the word of God day and night. He said seek his kingdom first and all the things you need will be added to you.
Go ahead.
He didn't say get rich quick or die trying. If you are a Christian, you don't have to die trying.
Amen.
Jesus already was made poor so you could be rich.
Go ahead.
But if you don't know that, you will not know that. If you do not know you hear about Jesus Christ, you would think you're suffering for Jesus. Well, that's not suffering for Jesus. That's being foolish for the devil, because he's a liar, and when we go against what's written, we're serving him.
Amen.
And we're pleasing him. Don't you know that whoever you yield your body to, whoever you yield your mind to, his servants you are?
Amen.
Whoever you obey, that's who you serve.
Amen.
Whether it's obedience to God, to righteousness, or sin unto death.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But we cannot live by the word of God if we do not know it.
That's right.
You know, one scripture says, my people perish for a lack of knowledge.
Amen.
Another one says, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge and gone into captivity.
Yes.
Christians are held captive when Jesus came to set the captives free.
Hallelujah.
What's wrong with you? Hallelujah. The truth is, if we're not studying, we're not going to do it. I was sharing with a girl earlier about healing, and I couldn't get far because she said, I believe the Lord put this on here for me for a reason.
Oh,
and I thought, well, okay then. So see, you can have what you say. You can have what you say. But we can't spend all day trying to do something when somebody just shut their ears. Remember when Jesus delivered that man with those demons and he was going into that city? They came out. They said, don't come to my city. Did you know Jesus did not go to their city? He didn't say, well, I'm going to pray for you. I'm mad at you. He just went on because he's a gentleman. He's knocking at the door. He's not trying to push it open.
Right.
But there is somebody who's not a gentleman. And
that's
the devil is not a gentleman. Even though he's defeated,
And
he's already defeated, if you don't know it, he'll pretend that he's not. So we want to thank God for his goodness and his mercy. Amen. So we do need to know the word of God in these evil times. He said, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. We are not to walk after the dictates of the flesh, but after the dictates of the spirit. Doth a fountain send forth at the same place sweet water and bitter? Can a fig tree, my brethren, bring olive berries forth? Either a vine figs? So can no fountain both yield salt water and fresh? You cannot serve God and mammon. We cannot serve God and idols. If we do not know the word of God, we would not know what he has said, and we would not be able to please him.
Amen.
Just go ahead and open up your Bibles to Exodus, the 20th chapter. I never thought that I would actually have to stand for myself. You know, you read things and you read about this and that and whatever and how folks are doing stuff, but you may be challenged one day. You may come face to face with an idol. You may come face to face with somebody telling you, remember when Nebuchadnezzar built that big old gold idol and he had the Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to come. Yeah. Well, hey, there's nothing new under the sun.
That's right.
Well, Hezekiah may not be talking, but somebody else could be. Yeah. But the thing about it is that the Lord, he will lead us in his word. And he said in Exodus 23 through 6, it declares plainly, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. And I didn't even know about the water. See, that's why we need to keep reading, because I all knew this, but I forgot about the water. And I thought about, yeah, I've seen some fishtail things, you know, some things with fishes with the little fin. So the Lord just covered everything here. He said, under the earth, thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them, for I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third generation of them that hate me. Wow. And I like this part, showing mercy upon thousands of those that love me. Because see, if you didn't know the mercy part, I knew the iniquity part before I knew the mercy part. So if you know the part of Job, how he was, you know, destroyed and how he was, everything was taken from him. And if you don't read the last chapter, then you won't know that God blessed him twice as much. So I grew up knowing about the hard things of Job. Some would say, you know, well, I heard somebody say they was poor as a church's mouse or something, you know, like the church ain't got no finances. What church they coming from, you know? But the thing about it is that if you don't know the word, some of these things may sound good. But he said that have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. You know what darkness is. You know what fellowship with unfruitful works of darkness is. But the Lord said, don't have fellowship with them. Don't hang around with them. Don't be carrying on with them. He said, reprove them. If you don't have enough guts to reprove them, at least don't be hanging around. Because I was looking at my Uncle George, about 85 years old. The Lord really blessed him. My sister take care of him. And so James, you know, we was at a function, and Uncle George started moving, you know. And you know, he started moving with he heard the music, so he was moving. And so I said, wow, Uncle George is moving. Now, Uncle George, you can move with the same praise and worship music in church when you honor the Lord. You know, there's such thing as dancing in the spirit. And so I was looking out, thinking about that. I said, but Uncle George don't know nothing about dancing in the spirit. So he's just kind of leaning on the little foolish side. But my sister made him sit down. But you know, the Lord is good, and my sister made him sit down.
Amen.
So I got to save my husband some face here. But I was reading on a certain religion, and the certain religion believed that deep within self is the light of God. Through certain teachings, they believe that the darkness of spiritual ignorance is dispelled. They believe that eternal peace is obtained through a certain flower, and meditating on their God's holy name. I didn't know what that was. In basic tenets and performing acts of service, good works. Okay? But we know that Jesus is the way. He's the only way, the truth, and the life. I remember when an evangelist, Billy Graham, used to say, Jesus is the only way. You know, no man can come to God but through Jesus. And I used to think, well, why is he saying that? Because everybody don't know that. I mean, you know, I was just in Alabama. I hadn't went nowhere. But when you go out, there's a lot of stuff competing for Jesus. There's a lot of things out there competing, but there's no competition. But if you do not know your God, if you do not know, he said, they that do know their God will do exploit. Amen. If you do not know your God, you will be deceived. Amen. You will be led to think it's okay. It's just another thing. No, no, it's not just another thing. Because God is going to save. He said, ask of me and I'll give thee the heathen for thine inheritance.
Amen.
How are you going to get the heathen if you ain't praying for them? If you ain't weeping for them? Like Sister was shedding a tear. She recognized darkness. We need to recognize. We need to recognize what time it is. Redeem the time because the days are evil. And not even just you know, love people because of what they have and stuff like that. Care more about their finances than their soul. People are going to be going to hell if we don't share the right things with them. And so the Lord has given that, and I thank him for that. Because when he said, ask of me and I give thee the heathen for thine inheritance, I never realized he's talking about people. We can pray for souls. I say, thank you, Jesus. I got a whole nation now. Sometimes we just look at one people. But I tell you, I was just thankful. I thank God for that.
Amen.
But we do not know that. We do not know that we can ask God for their souls. They will be lost.
Amen.
And knowing us and being lost is not a good idea, because you're supposed to be letting your light shine. So we want to thank God for this, and then the enemy tell people that you can't know God. I had a friend tell me, I believe there is some God. I know there's a supreme being, but you can't know him. But we can know the God through Jesus. We can know him through his word. Okay? And we know, some of them don't believe that, you know, God was in Christ, being born of a virgin or whatever. And the enemy teach things against that. But what if you do not know that God sent Jesus to die for the sins of the whole world? Born of the virgin birth, died and was raised again. You don't have anything to help. You don't have nothing to help people with. Because see, light does dispel darkness. Yes. The word of God does do it. And you don't have to argue. But you do need something to share, yes, with the people that don't know. Because not everybody know the gospel. I used to thought everybody knew the scripture. But no, everybody don't know. Everybody do not know what we know. Okay, not thinking that you can know God, not thinking that he was born, which is contrary to doctrine. God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself. The virgin birth, death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, God's only begotten Son. So we want to thank God for the victory, because we do serve Almighty God. We thank God for the victory in our life. We don't need to be surprised that man believe, you know, whatever they believe, apart from God and the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is Spirit of truth. How can you know truth if you don't have the Spirit of truth?
Amen.
Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Or Robert said this, he said, true religion will be tried. A man that has decided to live for God will have trouble with the devil. True religion will be tried. So if your religion ain't being tried, you probably, hey, check it out.
Amen.
True religion will be tried. When
Amen.
You decide to take a stand, the enemy will come against you and see what you got. See what you really got.
That's right.
You know? So I thank God for that, because he give us everything that we need. And we can go forth and let our light shine, knowing. I'm just thinking about these shoes, okay? Winfield had on some pretty shoes. I don't know what, you know, where he got the shoes from. But the shoes were pretty. They really were pretty. You know, I mean, I've seen lots of shoes, but the shoes were pretty. So I said, okay, those shoes are pretty. He said, I got the belt to match it. Look at it. So you know what he did? And I said, you know, Lord, he's not opposed to pretty shoes and stuff, you know, because women know how to dress with shoes. But you know what? We need to make sure that we have our life right with the Lord.
Amen.
So you may have friends who got all kind of things that you may not have. But just let them know that Jesus said a man's life is not in the abundance of things which he has. So it's not which he possessed. Thank you, sister. She be helping me preach here. So you know, and I was thinking about Jesus. I said, you know, when Jesus, he answered people after the spirit, you know. He didn't answer after the flesh. So I believe the Lord is saying it's time for us to know the word so we can give an answer from the spirit. You know, the disciples looking at the field and say, oh, these stones, isn't it so pretty? Isn't it so neat? Jesus said, not one stone going to be left. And this
Amen.
And that, whatever. And we know that happened. And then, you know, and then there, one time the Greeks came and they was like, oh, Jesus, they want to see Jesus. The Greeks are here. He said, unless a grain of wheat falls in the ground, you know, it can't do anything. So he was getting, he was always focused. And I said, Lord, help me to do that. Help me to be spiritually minded, because you got the Holy Ghost. You have an answer. You have an answer for everything. But if I'm just hanging in the world with everybody else, I'm not going to have an answer. If I'm not, and I want the Lord to be able to do that through me, and I know he will. And this is the last two scriptures. Therefore, if any man, that's a woman too, boy or girl, is in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. And all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ and has given to us the ministry of reconciliation.
Amen.
Did you know that you've been given the ministry of reconciliation?
Amen.
Not just pastor.
Amen.
Not just, you know, folk with titles. Christians.
Amen.
If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature.
Amen.
You got a ministry of reconciliation.
Yes.
Ain't no excuse for nobody. To wit, that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, not imputed their trespasses against them, and has committed unto us the word of reconciliation. Check that out.
Amen.
First, he gave us the ministry of reconciliation. Then he gave us the word of reconciliation. And you know what that means. You don't even have to have your own word. I mean, you can just ask God for a word, for a direction. He'll give you his word. We don't have to make up words.
Amen.
When he was called a priest years ago, and he was saying, the Lord called him into the ministry. I said, well, what are we going to say? He said, the Lord will tell us what to say. The Bible is full of stuff to say. So you know the thing about it. And he committed it first. He gave us the ministry of reconciliation. Then he committed to us the word of reconciliation.
Amen.
Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ. As though God did beseech you by us, we pray you, in Christ's stead, be ye reconciled unto God.
Yes.
For he had made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God. Then he tells us this, we still don't have any excuse. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. You can be wise in the world,
amen,
but you can be unwise in the Lord.
Amen.
But he wants us to be wise. We can have both types. We can have, because Christians, they're Christians. You can have the wisdom of the Lord, and then you would know how to appropriate, you know, the other type
amen.
Of stuff.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.